Good morning, Bios Baptist Church. Today, we are 6 days away from Thanksgiving. We are now in the official countdown to Thanksgiving. So, today I want you to rejoice in the Lord for all that He has done. Thanksgiving is not just being thankful for what God has done, but bringing your tithe into the storehouse and giving to God. At that gate, every Sunday, we are to be thankful. We come to the gate with praise. And we come into His court, which is the sanctuary, with praise. We come to His gate with thanksgiving. So, we are merely approaching the holiday season. And to keep the season as beautiful as possible, I want to say rejoice. So what's going on today? We are doing a lesson. And today I want to bring to you the lesson, rejoice in the Lord for all He has done. In the Bible, the Lord cites in Psalms 90:10 that He promises you 80 years of life. Do be thankful for those years that God has given you. I will slow down. For some people have died this morning. Some people died a few minutes ago. Some people, a person might have just died just now. And who knows? Somebody could die before I finish this video. Be thankful for your life that you live, no matter what. Be glad that you have a church that loves you and cares about you. Be glad that you have a Lord that loves you and cares about you and protects you and keeps you from hurt, harm, and danger. Here at Bios, we want to express this Christmas. Some people will be spending Christmas under a bridge, out in the freezing cold, while we get to enjoy sitting by the fireplace, pulling presents from under a tree and out of stockings, roasting marshmallows. Some people don't get that joy. Some people wait in breadlines while we go and sit around a table with a big table of food. Some people don't get to eat anything while we get to stuff ourselves with a big, nice turkey. While we get to eat nice food, delicious food prepared by our family, some people don't get that. Some people, most people have a house to go home to this Christmas, beautifully decorated with Christmas ornaments, Christmas trees, lights, strings of hot cords on the tree, ornaments, presents under the tree, red wood burning in the fireplace, the mistletoe in the neighborhood entrance, lights in the yard, beautiful, beautiful decorations. the only decoration some people might get is the ones that are on street lights and not ones that are under interstate bridges. And for those who don't live in big parts of cities, they don't even get that. Some people might get killed this Christmas. Many people get hurt in accidents this year trying to overdo it. Some people get hurt on Black Friday or even killed. Many people lose their house because they don't know properly how to keep their alive tree from burning. For those who it hasn't happened to, again, be thankful, because it could happen to us all. You see, here at BIOS, this is a protection facility. This is my surrounding this Christmas. Some people don't get this. Some people don't even get the basic necessities of life. Some people don't even have a Bible, much less to have the amount of life that we have here, the amount of life we have here, and the amount of spirituality that we have here. For those who don't have it, we should not knock them, but we should be thankful that we are not in their situation, and we should pray that they should one day get to our status, where they have food. Please, I am asking you this Christmas, give to those who need. If you need, ask. And if you have, give. If you need and barely have, do what is Christian. Pray. Always pray. May God bless the hearers and doers of this word for the good and edifying of our heart and mind, our spirit and our soul. May God bless all of his people as they journey through this Christmas. In the name of Jesus, amen. Thank you.